In this video, I'm in the Jaguar Daimler Heritage Trust collection here at the British Motor Museum. And we're just moving some cars around for filming a special video, which has probably already appeared. But while I'm here, it makes sense to have a look around. There's so many cars here. That's the original concept, XJ220, from the Birmingham Motor Show launch in 1988. I remember it well. I was there. I remember seeing that car. This is the eventual production car. It's one of many production cars. So it's gone from a V12 with four-wheel drive to a V6 rear-wheel drive. This Jaguar XJR supported a world land speed record, the SSC, a Bloodhound support vehicle, Team Sky, a very expensive bike on it, Jaguar's exploits in Formula One are represented here, the Project 8 SV, and the gorgeous wish they'd made it. The C-X75 plug-in parallel hybrid hypercar with pantograph wiper. Interesting times. So that's a prototype used for testing, and sadly the car has been decommissioned and the battery removed, but lots of heritage on the walls here. There's a scale model of William Lyons' personal XJ6, which is in this collection. We'll go and see if we can find it in a moment. Lots of stuff representing. We've got the original Swallows here, XK120s, and a 140 next to it, Mark 1 there. A very rare Daimler XJS, a complete one-off, but they decided not to build, with an actual coupe roof and removable targa tops. There's a four-wheel drive XJS prototype, but there's been a lot of journalists have driven that. This is the last six-cylinder XJS and the last V12 XJS, James Bond XK8, complete with replica machine gun. This is interesting. These are the original doors from the factory when SS Cars Limited moved from Blackpool to Coventry in the 1930s, I think it was. 1928. So they think these were actually built by the factory. That's utterly remarkable stuff here. This is the last XK powered car. 1987, it says, Jaguar Sovereign. We've got an X-Type that's been supercharged. The only one built. That must be rather exciting. I've driven... No, I haven't. I've been a passenger in this car. It's a Daimler DS420. I think this is the last one built. Ah, this was the last car with an XK engine, not the XJ. That was the last Jaguar. Look inside, though. I've been chauffeured in this car. It has the same winding window handles as a Metro. Very peculiar specification. Obviously doing a bit of retrimming in that car at the moment. But look at this, XJ40 Coupe concept they never built. XJ40 Estate, but they never built, complete with a Perspex engine cover, so you can see what's going on underneath. One of those could-have-beens, could-have, should-have. Wonderful car. So it's well worth coming to check this collection out. They've currently got a separate exhibition in the main British Motor Museum on Daimler, so we'll go and have a look at that in a moment. But here's some more concepts that never saw the light of day, including a fully engineered XJ42, I think it is, prototype. XJ41 was the hard top, I think. Some very interesting windscreen wiper shenanigans going on. But this was the car that was meant to replace the XJS. But when Ford took over, they saw how much this project was going to cost and said, no, we're not doing that. So the project got shelved, and the XK8, which was basically a reskinned XJS, was a result of all that. But yeah, lots of interesting stuff here. Well, this is a head from an XJ4 engine, a four-cylinder XK engine, but they never actually put into production. And you can see the duplex chain, a six-cylinder engine, quad cam heads from a V12. This is an original D-type front end. They still own this car. It's an extraordinary collection, well worth your time to come and have a look. And here we can have a look inside the XJ220, they've managed to jam the doors up. These hydraulic rams had broken, but they found a way to jam the doors up, so you can actually have a look inside this original show car. It was all thought out, but yeah, it just never reached production in this form. And there is the mock-up V12 engine. An extraordinary project, the XJ220. Do look up the history of it. Yeah, quite remarkable indeed. So SS Cars got its name from Swallow Sidecars. And there is one attached to a Brough Superior. Here is Sir William Lyons' car, his personal car. I've had the pleasure of driving that one. XJ6, quite an early one, on the G plate from 1968. And yeah, it's just a wonderful collection. Her Royal Highness the Queen Mother's personal Mark 7, upgraded to Mark 8 specification. Mark 5 there as well, and a Mark 4. But also wonderful artwork on display, including the founder of Jaguar himself, Sir William Lyons, here pictured with his wife Greta. So now we've come over to the main museum building, sneaky peek, it's amazing, and we're taking in the Daimler exhibition over here. Because in 1960, Jaguar purchased Daimler. It was a rival until that point. And yeah, the history then gets quite interesting. We shall start over here with the oldest surviving Daimler. It's from 1897. The company only existed from 1896. Slightly confusing in those early days. It began as a subsidiary or an overseas offshoot of Daimler, the German company, which marketed its cars as Mercedes later on, and is still known as Daimler-Benz to this day. Now those two great companies have merged, but I think this was an early Daimler design of their own, and it would have had tiller steering when new. It's now got a wheel, and it's been to amazing places. The first owner used it for tours of Belgium and France, despite the fact, I mean, it was feeble. The top speed is something like 12 miles an hour. It's been up the Alps, and it was bought by the Jaguar Daimler Heritage Trust in 1984 and has been beautifully restored. It still often takes part in the London to Brighton memorial run for veteran cars, so that's great. This one, on the face of it, not in brilliant condition. But don't let the looks fool you. This is a car with great history, especially linked to Shelsley Walsh. It's a 1907 Daimler TP35. It's got a huge four-cylinder engine of 8.5 litres. And it was the quickest car up Shelsley Walsh on the day that circuit opened in, I think, 1905. And it's been up there several times since, the last only 2 years ago. So a remarkable history. This one, Daimler TA23 Clovelly Saloon, was owned by Mr. Welch of the Dunlop company, Dunlop Tires. But I think this is one of my favourite cars of Daimler's history. It's the Majestic Major. I have driven one. They are extraordinary. They will do 120 miles an hour thanks to a 4.5 litre Hemi Head V8. So it's a stately home, and you can see this one's very stately. This is a full-on limousine spec with extra seats and everything. Look at that interior. But yeah, quite extraordinary performance. And yeah, they are remarkable cars. Definitely one of Daimler's finest points. The Hemi Head V8 in smaller 2.5 litre form was used in the Daimler Dart, and some of you may have noticed this one here. This is a prototype. After Jaguar purchased Daimler, they said, can we improve the looks of the quirky Dart, which had a face like a frog, to put it mildly. So we've got E-type side light and indicator units. This work, this redesign was done by Sir William Lyons himself. And this is the first time I've seen this car. And it's fascinating. I think it's so much better than the original. But ultimately, still too labor intensive to build. And here is a section V8 engine. The Hemi Head V8, designed by Edward Turner, and yeah, quite a remarkable motor. But yes, ultimately they decided it wasn't worth the effort of putting together, which is a bit of a shame. Over here, we've got a big Daimler limousine, which was for the then chairman, kind of an example of everything you could do. And all possible extras. Look, we've even got a video recorder down there. We've got screens in the back of the headrests in 1995. And yeah, ultimately, I don't think they made any more of these. That is a complete one-off. Another car that used Edward Turner's 2.5-litre V8 was the Daimler V8 250. It's the, if you look at my other video on the S-Type, this is a missing link. So this is the Mark II Jaguar, but with that 2.5-litre V8 engine. These are lovely to drive. They're not in any way rapid, because they're not all that powerful, but they are so smooth, and that engine is so nice. For my money, this is the pick of the Mark II Jaguars. And then finally in this exhibition, we've got the Daimler Corsica, which is another of my favorites of the collection. A beautiful one-off convertible, originally built as a non-running prototype, but David Mark's garage, noted restorer of XJ40s and X300s, actually turned this into a fully running car, so it is now road legal, but absolutely beautiful. So that's the Daimler exhibition here at the British Motor Museum. It's definitely well worth coming along. This exhibition's on until January 2021. Just pay attention to the open dates, because this museum is not open every day. But yeah, it's definitely well worth a look. I mean, if we come and have a nose over here, for instance, there's the Range Rover, one of two that took part in the Darien Gap adventure, driving from North to South America. It's still got all the dents, it's still bashed about. And I'm pleased to say, I actually drove that a few years ago with those huge ramps on the roof. It was rather top heavy, but yeah, what an experience that was. So yeah, check out the British Motor Museum and the Jaguar Daimler Heritage Trust on their respective websites. There will be links in the description below. And thanks to both of them for letting me have a nose around in one of my favorite buildings anywhere in the world. Oh, there's NWL 576, the very first Morris Minor. It is quite the place. Farewell.